Hello and welcome to this video. Maybe you own a LEGO Technic Control Plus vehicle and you always wanted to use it with a physical remote because you don't like the touch control, or you always hesitated to buy a Control Plus vehicle because you never could use a physical remote. You always had to use your smartphone to control it. But that's not anymore, because now it's possible to control vehicles and builds in general directly with a powered up remote without any other device. And it's possible with all of the powered up devices, including Control Plus. And there's a slight limit. I can only make programs for the vehicles that I have. So don't panic. You have to upload a program to the hub, but I made programs so that you don't have to write your own one. But it only works for the devices or for the models that I have, because I can't write a program for a model that I don't have. So this uses PyBricks, and for everyone who hasn't thought of PyBricks yet, it's possible to upload small Python programs to the hub and then to run them locally without any other device after you uploaded them once. And since now it's possible to connect the hub directly with a powered up remote, you can connect the powered up remote to a hub that runs a Python program locally. And all of that might sound a bit technical, but we will follow the instructions step by step. And I will link a guide, an official guide by the PyBricks development team in the description, but you should be able to follow this video. And you can always write a comment, and it would be best to provide a timestamp and to write me what you wanted to do and what the problem was, so that I can help you in the comments. For the installation, you need a BLE, Bluetooth Low Energy compatible device that can use Google Chrome. For the installation, you need a BLE, Bluetooth Low Energy compatible device that can install the Google Chrome browser, so you can use your Android smartphone, or you can use your computer with Windows or Linux or stuff like that. But now, let's get to the actual uploading of the program. Here we are again. I will use the Edge browser from Microsoft in this video, but you can use whatever browser you want as long as it's based on Chrome. So you can use Google Chrome on Android or on Windows or Chromium, whatever you'd like to use. And this is the website that we'll use. I will link this website and all the other sites in the description. And now I will show all of the steps that we will do step for step until the model can be remote controlled. And first of all, we can go into the settings, because here we can remove the documentation. It's this window on the right, and it only takes space, and we don't need the documentation because we won't program in this video, so we can remove it. Next, we will have to get the code for the set that we want to use. For that, you can go to the site. Here is a list of the sets that I created layouts for by the set number. And if you don't know the set number, you can find it on the instructions, or you can find it on the box, or you can go to the LEGO website and search for the model. So in my case, I can go to shop, sets by theme, and I want to control the Control Plus off-roader. So I can go to LEGO Technic. And I can go to the off-roader. Now I can find the item number here. It's 42099. And I can go to this site again and open the code for 42099. Now here's a bit of text. We can simply select it and copy it. We don't need to program anything. We only have to copy the pre-made or the finished code for this model and paste it into the editor. So here we can paste it. And now we have to enable another feature, because we want to download this program to the hub. And for that, we have to include it into a firmware update. So we can go to the settings, we can go to firmware, and then we can select Include Current Program. This way, the code that's in this editor will be included in the next firmware that we download to the hub. And we will update the hub firmware, so you won't be able to connect it to the Powered Up app or to the Control Plus app anymore. But at the end of the video, I will show you how to undo that. But for now, we can put the hub into the update mode, and you can do that by pressing the green button on the hub until the lights blink purple. On the city hub, you might have to disconnect all devices that are connected to the hub, but for the Technic Control Plus hub, you can only press the green button until the light blinks purple. And now we can go to this button, install Pybrick firmware. We can select LEGO Bootloader and select Pairing. And now it will start. Hold the green button until you see this symbol, until it starts to upload the firmware, and then you can stop to press the green button. This moment will take a while, so I will make a cut and we'll see us when the firmware is uploaded to the hub. This I can change again, so the firmware upload is completed. And now the program for the remote control is stored on the hub itself, so we don't need this device anymore. And we will switch back to the model. Here we are again, and now we can turn the device on. First we have to press the green button on the hub, then it will turn on, and it will detect the motors. That can take a while, so you have to wait a few seconds, and then you can press both at the same time, the green button on the remote and the green button on the hub again. That will start the program and start the motor calibration sequence. And after the calibration sequence, you should be able to remote control your model. You can turn the buttons around if the control is reversed. To stop the program, you can press on the green button on the hub. That will stop the program. And then you can press and hold the green button on the hub again to turn the hub off. And it will be turned off if the blue LED of the hub stops to blink. And now to the last part, how to get back to the original LEGO firmware to use the Powered Up app or the other apps again. I will use the Powered Up app because that's compatible with all of the LEGO hubs, and that will make it easier to download the program or to download the original firmware. But now I have to go back into the update mode. Keep in mind to disconnect the cables from the city hub, from the two-port hub. I don't have to do that since this is the Control Plus hub, and now I can press and hold this button until the light starts to blink in purple again, and I can go into any layout and connect to the hub. And that will start the update process. So that was it for this video. Keep in mind that I'm always open for suggestions, for problems that you had. Feel free to write them to me in the comments. Also, you can make your own layouts if you can program a bit for models that I don't have. I would love to add them to the list. Or you could make push requests on GitHub. But for now, thanks for watching. See you in the next video, and bye.